InSight's automatic Mistie analysis provides a fast and effective method for balancing multiple datasets. By running the Mistie analysis wizard, we can adjust the amplitude, phase, and time shifts of our datasets to achieve a best fit match between volumes. In this example, we use the automatic Mistie tool to correct the differences between a 3D and a 2D volume. This will enable us to pick a horizon through the original 2D and onto the newly acquired 3D volume. To get started, let's look at the two volumes side by side. In the map view, create an arc line along one of the 2D lines, then out into the surrounding 3D volume. Open the arc line view and take a look at the result. I'll need a group to show both volumes at the same time. Here's one that I prepared earlier. By putting the 2D volume above the 3D, it will be displayed where the two volumes overlap. In the centre, we can clearly see the transition between the volumes. On the left, we see the 2D data, and on the right, we see the 3D data. The status bar at the bottom of the window tells us information about the displayed volume below the mouse cursor. Okay, so we're interested in picking this positive event. We'll use the propagator guided manual picker to pick this event. Oh dear, that doesn't look good. Picking is going to be difficult until we get this Mistie sorted out. Let's correct this before continuing to pick this horizon. Go to View, Mistie Correction, Automatic. Remember, each volume in InSight is assigned to a class. InSight uses this information to identify the data type and to control the display properties. Automatic Mistie Correction will only be applied to volumes of the same data type, so make sure the correct type has been assigned to your volume before continuing. Our data volumes are full stacks, so we'll select the full stack as the class and add the 3D and 2D volumes. We need to select which data to use as a reference. When performing misties, the reference data remains constant, and the other data volumes are adjusted to match it. The reference can be a single 2D line or an entire 3D volume. In this case, we'll select our 3D volume and have the 2D lines adjusted to match it. Choosing the right correlation window is critical to getting good results. You can use a fixed time interval for the comparison, or a window based on a horizon. In this case, I will choose a fixed time interval near the horizon I'm picking. We'll keep the default values for everything else. The Mistie correction will be calculated for the vertical shift, phase, and amplitude. But we can control what happens to each of these individually. The best match for each of these parameters can be determined for the entire volume, line by line, or not calculated at all. If we choose per volume, all the lines in RTD will share the same correction. If we choose per 3D volume / 2D line, each line will have its own correction. In this case, we're interested in calculating a separate vertical shift for each 2D line. So let's use the per 3D volume 2D line option. We also need to address phase and amplitude differences. So let's set phase and amplitude to per volume. So what is InSight doing? The Mistie process first calculates the optimal correction for each intersection independently. It then determines an overall adjustment that best fits the individual corrections to minimize the total residual Mistie. Once complete, a table will appear with an overview of the proposed changes. If you need a record of the proposed changes, the data can be copied by right-clicking and selecting Copy to CSV. Before applying these corrections, InSight gives you the option to QC the results at each intersection. These first two columns describe the intersection for that row. The applied column shows the adjustments made to the given line or volume. The residual column shows the remaining Mistie at this intersection. You can double-click on any row to open a view of that intersection. Here you can see a visual comparison between the uncorrected data, the ideal correction, and the final correction. These graphs show the impact of different shifts and phases on the correlation coefficient between the traces at the intersection. This final graph shows the spectra of the intersection traces. Before you continue, remember that Mistie corrections are applied for all users of the data. Corrections are applied to the volumes, not just single InSight sessions. These changes can impact others, so be careful. Once complete, the corrections will be applied whenever the volume is loaded or displayed. phase rotation requires a lot of calculation, which can slow insight down when reading traces, especially for time slices and horizon amplitude extraction. If you find that working with phase rotated data is too slow, export a copy of the volume, which will store the data with the corrections applied. So, can we follow the event better? Let's have a look at our arbitrary line again. You can see that the newly corrected volumes match significantly better. Picking across the volumes is much easier for the interpreter. Manual corrections can be applied at any time through the volume configuration dialog by double-clicking a volume in the control panel. Here you can see changes apply to the volume and make manual adjustments to the vertical shift, phase, and amplitude scale. Remember, you must be the owner of the volume in order to edit it. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.doug.com. And remember, have fun with insight.